Hello, I am Sinfogel, and today we're checking out the Sub-Zero, My Past, My Future Battle Challenge. That's so dramatic, I felt so corny saying that, dude. Anyway, this stage is not too terrible because the mission is easy, but the gimmick is a flying zone. What is a flying zone, you may ask? Flying zone is a field effect that boosts flying type damage. It's like the Sonic Day equivalent for flying type attacks in this game. And Malva immediately opens the fight with flying zone, and she recasts flying zone after sinking. Also, her entire team has flying zone extension, so this is going to be a permanent feature of the fight. You cannot just wait it out. Naturally, Malva's team has many flying type attacks, and she's got barrel roll too, which lowers all sources of move damage by 20% while flying zone is active. Removing flying zone is in your best interest, and there are a couple ways of doing so. You can override it with another zone, or you can bring defog. You have to bring another zone specifically, because zones can coexist with weather and terrains at the same time, so you cannot use hail to replace a zone. That's not how it works. If you lack alternate zones or defog, you can also weaken Malva by dropping her attack and special attack. That effectively accomplishes the same function as removing flying zone. Besides that, Malva has Defense Crush 9, which is a very dangerous passive. Whenever Malva attacks, she drops your tank's defense by one stage, and Malva also has Swift, which translates into spread defense drops. Your first priority should be bringing a tank who raises the party's defense, and with Unbending as a passive, that blocks defense drops. Also, special defense raises are welcome, because Malva's Swift hurts if left unchecked. Now, the catch is that the event mission demands a single Ice-type pair. Huh. Well, there is the fainting conditional, that's a standard. Only one sync pair is allowed to faint for the mission to count, but that's it really. We barely have Paldean pairs, so I'm appreciative of this. That means team building is quite flexible for this one. This doesn't happen often. However, note that Malva has a weakness to electric. Her Sidemons have the ice weakness, so you could bring an ice type pair plus an electric type pair to rush down Malva's team. So I could say just bring Thunderbolt Red, lol, but we can be more insightful than that. There are ice types who handle Malva fairly well. You have Irida with her Ice Wish. This is also the time to bring Take a Glaceon if you hatched any. Ketsis is the best accessible ice type counter because his Noble Roar quickly neuters Malva's offenses. Signasud N checks Malva really well for similar reasons. Bryson is trying his best with Haze for star removal. And there is Dana, who is a robust tank with defense raises as well as special defense raises, and with a super effective up next, she can support either ice types or electric type pairs. As for raw utility pairs, I would prioritize defoggers, because defog removes zones. Darak is a phenomenal Malva response, because he packs Feather Dance to neutralize attack raises. BP Faulkner helps for similar reasons, because his 3-5 grid unlocks Overwhelm 9. And Lysia can disrupt all foes with Twister Flinches. Alright, we're going with my alt for this one. This account is bare bones when it comes to investment, and really, our best option is spamming sync pairs from Legendary Adventures. Ketsis just happens to be a solid Malva check, and he's a nice type. Given the mission flexibility, we can afford the good old Sycamore plus Hop core. These two work wonders, because they buff all core stats, and when combined with Ketsis' Noble Roar debuffs, we can survive Malva even on their flying zone. You can tank with either Hop or Sycamore. I went with Hop because it's cheaper on Synchorps in the end, but you cannot avoid greening your tank. You need a few extra passives to improve your defensive consistency. Hop specifically wants his trainer move Muipo Refresh 3 in order to maximize the party's critical hit rate, with the addition of Unbending to block Malvai's Defense Crush 9 debuffs. If you are tanking with Sycamore, he wants Impervious for the same reason. Getsis surprisingly doesn't need a grid for this one, but I would highly recommend Noble Roar Double Drop to make his debuffs twice as fast. On screen you are seeing full sync grid recommendations, but I used very minimal grids for the actual clear. Alright, let's get to it. Many of our battle preparations were completed on team building, so this fight is not demanding on execution. Treat this as a regular encounter. The rule of thumb is use one action per character every turn. That helps upkeep your sync countdown. Your first priority is resetting for Hop's trainer Muipo Refresh 3. It's very likely to happen, but you really want to raise the party's critical hit rate up to plus 3. That upkeeps your offense and it makes things so much easier. If Hop procs more Muipo Refreshes, all the better. Those defense raises are more than welcome. Sycamore takes a first sync because that's how he procs his Geomancy buffs. That delicious plus 6 special attack, special defense and speed for a party. Meanwhile, Getsis spams Noble Roar to neutralize Malvai's stat raises. I suggest doing so until Malvai uses Giga Impact, and that is turn 5, right before she sinks. Of course, with Noble Roar Double Drop, you would do this twice as fast. Speaking of Giga Impact, it would be preferable for Hop to be at full health before tanking it, and that's because of his healthy benefits 5 passive. That's an equivalent to multi-scale in the main series games, whereby if Hop is at full health, he receives half the damage he normally would. So don't be shy, pop those potions. After Malva sinks, you should switch gears to full-on offense. What's nice about the Hop and Sycamore is that they are the rare kind of support who can dish out decent damage. So use Behemoth Bash and Moonblast respectively if you have the gauge for it. They help push damage on center while Getsis Glaciate takes care of the side mods. Now, this party can present gauge contention, because these are expensive moves we are spamming here, but you should always prioritize Getsis Glaciate, that gives you the most bang for your buck in terms of DPS. Malva got a little violent here, she just kept spamming Bravebird, and without potion multiple refreshes, it's hard for Hop to outlast that, but that's alright. Sycamore can take over with his Horn Leech recovery, and remember, one sync pair is allowed to faint and the mission still counts, so we are still in the clear. With Malva taken care of, one Glaciate should take care of the Sidemons, but whoa, baby, that is a heatwave crit right there, but Getsis refusing to give up, he managed to hang on. Bit of a close call, but yeah, that should do it. Hope this video helps, but thank you for watching, take care, and I hope to see you another time.